Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock. And everyone who listens to these words of mine, but does not act on them, will be like a fool who built his house on sand. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, and it collapsed and was completely ruined." The Gospel of the Lord. Today's Gospel is a beautiful Gospel that illuminates something that is true for all of us. In it, Matthew refers to, and Jesus tells us, that we must listen to the will of the Father and do His will. At the beginning of Matthew's Gospel, Matthew lists out specifically what that will of the Father is when he lists out the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are the meek. Blessed are those who seek righteousness. Blessed are the merciful. These are the people who have heard God's word and who are living it. And this is what it is to be a disciple, to live the Beatitudes. And in doing that, we build our lives on the rock of faith, which assures us Jesus, God, and eternity. I've seen this gospel lived out before my very own eyes this very month. The last few weeks. One of the great joys of my life is to serve as chaplain to Mother Teresa's sisters, the Missionaries of Charity, here in San Francisco. Every afternoon, we go to a certain location where we put on a meal and feed the homeless. Sometimes up to 150 or more homeless people every day gather, and we provide them with a meal, we spend time with them. We pray together, we eat together, and we form community. It's a very big part of my life, something I love doing. And I saw this gospel lived out as I was doing that with the sisters just recently. We had gathered as we normally do, and we're getting ready to open the kitchen and the dining room to provide the meal. The homeless had gathered and were waiting quietly, some of them sitting on the pavement, others lined up in a line on the side of the road. Suddenly, to our shock, a man appeared from a local building, a tall, big man, red-faced with anger, and he started shouting at us, very angrily, with great rage in his voice. He began to demand that the homeless leave, and he said they dare not be there, they had no right to be there. He demanded that they leave, and he started shouting at them. Then, to my complete horror, he even started shouting at the sisters, demanding to know why they had brought the homeless to his neighborhood. I became quite angry. I reacted in a very human way. But sister, seeing that, stepped in, and before I could go talk to the man sternly, which I had intended to do, sister went between us and went up to him, not sternly, but with love. And even as he was shouting at her, red-faced, she stood there smiling, looking at him quietly, loving him, not judging him. She asked him what was bothering him, and she listened as he explained his fear of the homeless. And then she reassured him and absolutely promised him that no one would come to any harm and everything would be okay. He remained shouting for a little while, but then left, and we went on with our business, praying and feeding the poor. I remained quite upset and angry at this man, and I was quite judgmental about him. I considered even writing a letter of complaint to the parish about him, because he was a teacher in the parish school, and I thought this was very bad behavior for a teacher. to give as an example to his young students. But I didn't do anything. I let it go and I gave it to God in prayer. And I'm glad I did, because this is what happened. Just 2 weeks after that had happened, I was with the sisters again, and we were at another location, this time doing a summer camp for poor children in the city. We had arranged an entire week of events, of prayers, teaching, games, activities, and we had a lot of volunteers helping us. One day, sister came to me with a smile and she said, "I want you to meet our volunteer, a new volunteer who's coming today." And to my complete and utter shock, in comes that angry-faced man I had met just 2 weeks ago shouting at us. He was there smiling, a little bit sheepish, a little bit embarrassed, and he was there to volunteer, to work with the poor children. In fact, he spent the entire day doing activities with them. Sister had touched his heart. With her love and her mercy, she had opened within him that which was already there, the Word of God. And this good man found the goodness within him, got beyond his fear and his anger to the extent where now he was actually with us, shoulder to shoulder, volunteering and helping the very people he had been so afraid of. Because sister hadn't judged him the way I had. She had instead been Christ-like. She had simply loved him. She had understood him. And she had given him mercy. And she had brought peace to his heart and to all of us. And so now, because of that, encountering Jesus in sister enabled this man to find within himself the Word of God that had been planted there, and for him to find the Holy Spirit and to live that Word of God, to get beyond his fear, to get beyond his anger, and to find love and peace, and to be with us shoulder to shoulder, serving the poor, living the Beatitudes. That is the story of the faith for all of us. We are all called in a similar way. All of us will encounter Jesus, will encounter his mercy, and that will allow us feel and hear his word, hear it and feel it in our hearts where it already lives, so that we can live it ourselves in our lives and find the peace of Christ that is ours. And where do we find the strength to do this? In Jesus himself, when especially he calls us to Mass, to the Holy Eucharist, where he gives us himself, body and blood, soul and divinity, feeding the word within us, helping it grow, giving us himself so that we can indeed become remade in his image and live the word, get beyond our limitations and build our houses on rock and not on fear, and therefore live the faith and have the surety of eternal life. This is what Jesus gives us, himself. It is our gift from God. It is our birthright. It is within all of us. And when we find Jesus and listen to him and accept him, we are able to live it fully in our own lives. For this great gift, we thank Jesus. And in this season of Advent, as we prepare for Christmas, we remember that Jesus is coming into our lives. And we prepare for that, to be willing to meet him when he does greet us, to hear him and to let him live in us so that we can live the Beatitudes and be him to all we meet. This is the promise that we're looking forward to in Christmas. This is the gift of God to all of us. And this is the life we all are called to live. For that, we give praise and thanks. So, together, as we look forward to this great season of hope that is Christmas, let us join in a prayer that we are open to the Holy Spirit, that we are open to Jesus, to be able to see him, especially in the distressing disguise of the poor, and that we're able to live his word for all that we encounter. For this, let us pray to the Lord using the words that Jesus himself gave us, and as a family together pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. And in this Advent season, to all the viewers and your families of Shalom World, we wish you a joyous, peaceful, and loving Christmas. May God bless you and your family and keep you close to His Sacred Heart. Amen.